there's such a growing demand for mental health services. All the while, the number of providers in the world has remained relatively flat. My name is John Sockel. I'm co-founder and COO of Limbix. We make apps and VR for treating mental health disorders. We chose virtual reality because we saw probably 20 years worth of research, maybe 300 peer-reviewed publications that had showed VR play some sort of meaningful role within mental health care. Within cognitive behavioral therapy, there is a technique called exposure therapy. And exposure therapy is the idea of flooding someone with the thing that causes them distress. So a really simple example could be if you're afraid to drive or couldn't get behind the wheel.
So this is the Limbix headset.
Once that therapist knows that you're ready and comfortable to do this exposure, the therapist might start you off on a quiet street. And so you're in your virtual reality headset as a patient. And as the therapist next to me, as I'm going through this as a patient, all the while sees what I see in VR on their tablet.
What we have here is the tablet interface.
And on that tablet, they can choose that quiet street. They can also choose a busy road like a highway or a tunnel or something much more anxiety inducing like a bridge. And so the therapist will slowly but surely gradually expose me to more and more stressful environments. And then while I'm viewing these, and going through that, that therapist is also teaching me coping techniques to be more comfortable with what I'm doing and things that I can apply to my own life when I'm actually in the car afterwards. There's much more serious examples around PTSD and other phobias as well, where exposure therapy can be really helpful.
It's the 21st century exposure therapy. It's as close as you can get to real life without going into real life, and the data shows that it works as well as going into real life. So for therapists, it's a beautiful tool.
It's critically important, we think, to take them through a rigorous FDA process. The alternative that people have done to date is basically making direct-to-consumer apps. You know, you don't want to send people on their own at home to do things that could potentially make them worse. And so in the last couple of years, the FDA has rolled out a new therapeutic class called prescription digital therapeutics. And basically, the FDA is now attempting to evaluate apps the same way that they evaluate drugs. Make sure that the apps that doctors and others are providing have some sort of basis of evidence that they work. But really, it's about trying to provide lots of access for lots of different problems, because ultimately we want to make these treatments available around the world. I think the way we improve access to these treatments is with cost-effective technology that can be democratized around the world.
Thanks for watching. If you like this video, give it a like and subscribe to FreeThink Now for more great videos every week.